admits the heat of the latest console battle between PlayStation 5 and the Xbox Series X. Tim Sweeney, aka Tim Swindle, inserts his foot directly in his mouth once again. Why anything this man says cannot be trusted? Let's get into it. What's up, people? What's up, people? What's up, people? It is your boy, MM2K, back again with another video. Do me a favor before we get into this one. Hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button. Rock those bells for notifications, please, so you know when your boy's dropping these doses. I appreciate all of y'all straight up because y'all know the deal. Y'all know the reason. Y'all know the slogan. I am not too proud to ask. Let's get into it. All right, so we know that we're closing down the eighth generation of gaming, which brought us to PlayStation 4 and the Xbox One. The Xbox Series X appears to be a more direct effort from Xbox to compete, hopefully a lot better than they did during the eighth generation. And so therefore there's been a lot of back and forth, a lot of evaluation of who's showing what better, who has better presentation, who's going to have the upper hand, all that other stuff. Well, Tim Sweeney interjects himself into this whole debate by working with people at Sony to create this tech demo for the forthcoming Unreal Engine 5. And the demo is impressive. I would be lying to say otherwise. I've had my issues that I've been vocal about with not so much the demo, but how Jeff Keighley hyped up what was simply a demo and made it seem like that it was going to be a retail game that was shown. But that's for a different video. We'll get into that later in this week, possibly. Right? But the demo within itself is impressive, no doubt about it. But here's where Tim Sweeney interjects himself with his typical misleading babble that makes us think that something exists that does not in totality. He goes and he makes a point to say things about the PlayStation 5 in relation to Unreal Engine that would make it seem like that the tech demo that you saw was not possible anywhere else, which is an utter lie, all right? Now, why do I say that he said that? Because he said it. Take a look here. The Unreal Engine 5 tech demo would absolutely not be possible at any scale without these breakthroughs that Sony's made. And that comes from Tim Sweeney, right? So the unsuspecting gamer listening to that would think, reasonably so, that, oh, this can't be done anywhere else. This amazing thing that I saw just can't be done on any other platform. That Tim Sweeney went and developed Unreal Engine 5 solely for the PlayStation 5. And they both end in 5. Why the hell not, right? All right. And to show that he even got some of my good friends with this bibble babble. All right. As you can see here, and big ups to the homie King Thrash. King Thrash did invite me on the Roundtable podcast. Definitely check them out on YouTube. Very entertaining and very game-centric podcast. He invited me on here to talk this out, and I wasn't able to make it. So it wasn't that, I don't want to make it seem like that Thrash didn't want to have a robust discussion around this. He definitely did, and hopefully we can line something up, because me and him got to get together on some other stuff anyway. With that being said, he got my homie Thrash. He said they praising the PS5, said the demo is impossible anywhere else. And I said, huh? I didn't see that. I could be wrong. Can you show where they said that demo wasn't possible anywhere else? And of course, he shows the exact same thing that I just posted to you guys. So they got the homie Thrash. You know what I'm saying? Tim Sweeney with all his bibble babble. Here's the problem, though. As a follow-up to that, to the back and forth me and Thrash had, you know what I'm saying? And it ain't about that, but what I was trying to elaborate as far as I'm not doubting that PlayStation 5 with this ultra fast SSD can possibly do some things. What in totality? I don't know. I'm not saying anything until Sony shows us. But I'm not saying wholeheartedly I doubt that it can do anything special. You know what I'm saying? That can do something that can enhance games in a special way. I don't know yet until PlayStation puts it in layman's terms. I'm not saying that's not possible. What I'm saying here is per what Tim Sweeney, aka Tim Swindle, is saying. He's not making that clarification. He's trying to play on that debate, the fact that we're having that debate rather right now, and he's trying to appease the fact that he partnered with Sony and in all likelihood got paid for it, and he's trying to be overzealous with his words, and in other words, saying things, trying to correlate things that don't go together, you know what I mean? Because he got paid. Tim Sweeney is infamous for this. I done showed y'all in previous videos that he done said stuff, that he's backtracked on stuff, that he's just flat out lied about things because it was a duffel bag presented to him. You cannot trust anything coming out this man's mouth, right? Now to wrap this all up pretty much, well, to start wrapping it up with a bow, this is what I said. I said, this is why more clarification is needed. Sweetie loves being cute with his words. Let's take that original tweet. The Unreal Engine 5 tech demo would absolutely not be possible at any scale, without these breakthroughs that Sony's made. That's what Tim Sweeney said, right? Bada boom. While Epic wouldn't comment on any potential performance, this is after the fact, differences between a PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X, Sweeney confirmed that the features shown today, like real-time global illumination and virtualized geometry, are going to work on all next-generation consoles. Now, before y'all damage control and y'all say, hold on, but those are just certain features. No. In his cute wording, he said, the tech demo would not be possible at any scale without these breakthroughs that Sony made. Here's the point that I was trying to make. Is that when he was saying without breakthroughs that Sony made, we don't know what particular breakthroughs that he was talking about. Was he talking about the breakthrough of a console maker coming up with computation units or whatever? He could have been talking about a facet of things. He could just be talking about the fact that the SSD is fast. Because if he's merely talking about a console maker making a fast SSD, Xbox Series X also has a fast SSD. So what he's trying to do is he's trying to tap into this whole dynamic or fantastic SSD capabilities that supposedly with PlayStation 5, and I'm not doubting that. He's trying to tap into that lingo, appease Sony because he got the duffel, and correlate Unreal Engine 5 with that, which is a farce. Because the breakthrough again that he could be talking about is just simply fast SSD, which in that vein, Xbox has one too. You know what I'm saying? So, he had to backtrack because he got cute with his words, right? And this is why I say you can't trust this man. You know what I mean? And then he comes through again. He says, he kind of lets you know, yeah, I got the duffel from PlayStation, man. Y'all got to be easy on him, brother. He says, the Unreal Engine 5 demo on PlayStation 5 was the culmination of years of discussion between Sony and Epic on future graphics and storage. The Nanomite and Lumen Tech Pioneer will be supported on both the PlayStation 5 and the Xbox Series X, and will be awesome on both. Oh, no, 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 no. You can't believe this guy. No, no, no. And to finally wrap this all up in a nice fine bow, I bring it to this tweet right here from this Twitter follower who says, people are actually believing anything Tim Sweeney actually say. They've been lying, or Epic Games actually say, they've been lying to you for the past 12 years. And they have a great illustration of how they've been lying. Tim Sweeney says PC is dead for games. Then somebody from Epic says PlayStation 4 praises the perfect gaming PC. Okay. And then lastly, now we got this. We got Tim Sweeney says PS5 better than top end gaming PCs. Look, again, I close this out with this. I am not doubting. I don't know. Sony has to show us. I am not doubting that the SSD in the PlayStation, because of how it's put together, could possibly do some great things and some special things in gaming. I'm not doubting that. I don't know yet. We got to see. Sony has to show us in full, tangible terms how that's so. What I'm saying to you is that what Tim Sweeney tried to pull is he tried to tie his Unreal Engine tech to that claim from Sony. The Unreal Engine tech, the Unreal Engine demo has nothing to do with that claim. Those are two totally different things. But Tim Sweeney is a con artist and he's an opportunist. And if he's not whining about something, he's lying about something, all for the sake of his benefit. And like I've told you time and time again, gamers, I don't know how much tangible proof that you need. You are not to trust this man. No. You're not to trust him at all. All right. Because Tim Sweeney is such a con man that he should officially get his name changed to Tim Swindle. Period. And that's it from your boy MM2K. Hey, yo, let me know what you think about what I had to say in the comment section below, because like I always say, who cares what I think? But if you did like what I had to say, check out the links below to follow me. Those links will lead you to the Broadband Bullies, PNTS Network, Hard Knock Digital Culture, and yes, the Stadia Dosage. And with all that said, no. Don't listen to that man. Y'all better have a wonderful gaming day. Peace.